This conference will now be
गुड
recorded.
आफ्टरनून मैम, गुड
गुड
आफ्टरनून मैम,
बाहर
होप आई एम ऑडिबल. या मैम,
या मैम, गुड आफ्टरनून मैम. ये बैठो ना, क्या परेशान हो तुम? हाँ, चश्मा दिख रहा है.
Good afternoon all. Welcome to induction program, Kelly College of Pharmacy, Bengaluru. Those who have enrolled for diploma course, B-Pharm course, and then Pharm-D course. Welcome you all. Today we are going to you are going to have an introduction about the committees which we have. These three committees, that is anti-ragging committee. Am I audible? Hope I'm audible. Anti-ragging committee.
No, ma'am, your voice is not clear, ma'am.
GRC committee, grievance redressal committee. It's not clear. Is it
no,
clear? Am I audible?
No, ma'am.
Not audible, ma'am.
Hello.
Your voice is not audible, ma'am.
Am I audible?
Your voice is not audible, ma'am.
This is not audible.
Yes, ma'am.
Now can you hear me? Hope I'm audible.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So we have anti-ragging committee. Then the grievance redressal cell, GRC committee. Then one more committee we have in our college, that is on the anti-sexual harassment committee. Anti-ragging cell. As you were all aware of ragging, ragging is the term used for so-called initiation rituals practiced in higher education institutions in South Asia countries, including India, Bangladesh, and Sri Lanka. Act, anti-ragging law in India. Act means, act in India, we have AICT, All India Council for Technical Education Act, that is implemented, enforced, came into enforce in the year 1987. Section 52 of AICT Act 1987, in that ragging, anti-ragging regulations, rules we can find. Ragging is nothing but, so any form is a menace and it is totally banned in all respect as per the orders of Honorable Supreme Court. To deal with the incidences of ragging, an anti-ragging committee has been constituted in our institutions. There are several objectives to constitute anti-ragging committee. Yes, main objectives are to create a healthy and congenial academic environment in the college campus and in the hostel. Then main objective will be completely avoid the occurrence of ragging in any form in the college campus, and to promptly and stringently deal with the incident of ragging brought into a notice. And the main objective will be to generate an atmosphere of discipline and brotherhood in the college campus, in the college premise. This is an anti-ragging committee. Here you can find members. Principal Sir Dr. Raman Tank will be a chairperson. Then myself, Dr. Ansuya Patil, will be the member. Vice Principal Dr. Shivkumar Sir will be a member of anti-ragging committee. Dr. Subhash Karki Sir will be a member. And then Dr. Rajamma, member of the committee. And then parent representative, Geeta's parent will be one of the representative committee member. And then non-teaching staff will be a member, Mr. J.N. Biradar in the anti-ragging committee. Members in the house, Geeta Rao will be of anti-ragging committee, and student representative Aditi, and then student representatives are there in the committee. Then external members from police department, Kavita Bai will be a member of this anti-ragging committee. Then NGO, from NGO external member, Ms. Sharmila John will be NGO member, external member as external member. These are the members of anti-ragging committee and their contact number, email ID. Yeah, fundamental rights of human being, rights to equality, rights against discrimination, rights to freedom, speech and expression, rights to freedom association, assembly, movement, residence, occupation, right to life, and right against exploitation. Ragging means any act by disorderly conduct cause of physical. Is there any disturbance?
From your voice,
ma'am, voice is not clear, ma'am, and not audible.
Ma'am, you're not audible.
Audible, not audible.
People,
excuse me, ma'am, your voice is not audible.
Hello, ma'am, your voice is not audible.
Hello, ma'am. Ma'am, voice is not audible.
Ma'am, your voice is not audible.
Ma'am, please unmute yourself, ma'am.
Ma'am, your voice is not audible.
Can you please unmute yourself, ma'am? We are not able to hear.
Ma'am, your voice is not audible, ma'am. Ma'am, unmute. Ma'am, unmute yourself, ma'am. Ma'am, your voice is not audible, ma'am.
Is any act by disorderly conduct cause of physical or physiological harm or using, playing, doing it will be the law, right? Forms of physical abuse. These are there are in this activity will be facing future hardships. It makes better.
Ma'am, your voice is not audible.
And those I'm not audible.
Ma'am, your voice is not audible, ma'am.
Maybe problem with the network. Is that you're audible, but I'm not audible, right? Hello?
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
ma'am. You hear me? Okay, fine. Thank you. Yes, thank you. Thank you so much. Yeah. Raggers, yeah, excuses of raggers. Raggers and those who are rag become a great friend. You should not be scared of ragging. Okay. In your mind, it should not have negative about the ragging. Ragging will be taken care. Yeah, raggers, the moment you enter into the college premise, yeah, you can make out easily raggers and non-raggers. In the right color in the image, you can find the raggers' behaviors are totally different from non-raggers. Yeah, effects of ragging. There are the severe effects on victim and victim family, and then it will have an impact, negative impact on the educational. Anti-ragging committee members are nominated and then headed by the head of the institution with respective of civil and police administration, a local media, NGO, non-government organizations, faculty members, parents, students, etc. will be the nominated members of anti-ragging committee. This is all about anti-ragging in India, anti-ragging law in India, the Kerala Prohibition of Ragging Act 1998. Ragging directly or indirectly or abetting within or outside an education institution, within the institution or outside institution, will be considered as an offense. Okay, offenders will get, they have to undergo rigorous punishment as per law, imprisonment up to 2 years, and sometimes with the fine, and both fine as well as imprisonment. Fine will be 10,000 based on the conviction. Punishment will be suspended or dismissed or debarred from gaining admission in any of the institutions. So this is as per the law. Punishment under IPC Indian Penal Code, there are several sections, 304, if a victim undergone a suicide or murder, under the section 304, murder, life imprisonment or 10 years, and then as per section 306, abetment of suicide, and then as per the IPC section 307, attempt to murder, imprisonment of 10 years, and fine. A person is injured, then it will be life imprisonment. Punishments under IPC Penal Code, there are, we have gone through, there are several sections. As per the IPC section 326, voluntarily causing grievance hurt by dangerous weapons, then punishment will be life imprisonment and fine. Life imprisonment may be for 10 years, or both, it is fine and imprisonment. Offenses, yeah, as per the IPC special reference to girl candidates sections, there are several sections. You can find left hand side the various sections, 509 and its offense and punishment. These are the several sections. Offenses are insulting women by word or signs, then punishment will be 3 years. These all various sorts of ragging offense. As per the section IPC 354, outraging modesty of women, then sexual harassment, voyeurism, taking images, stalking, rape, vegetative state, in rape up to imprisonment up to 7 years or lifelong imprisonment, or both. Punishment differs as per the section and offense punishment. A victim has to, offender has to undergo punishment, rigorous punishment. Does ragging affect the ragger? Yes, of course. Ragging does not spare even its perpetrators. Those found guilty of ragging may be suspended, blacklisted, debarred, and then expelled from the college. Yeah, make a campus ragging free. Go ahead, report ragging. Ragging is a crime. Don't rag. Don't be mute witness to ragging. So let's make campus ragging free. Coming to second committee. So far we came to know about anti-ragging committee existing in our institution, GRC. Second one is GRC. Let me brief you. GRC is nothing but grievance. Any kind of grievance will be reported. there is a committee, grievance redressal cell, GRC, students grievance redressal cell. Grievance redressal mechanism, any complaint, a complaint that has been formally presented to a management representative, any sorts of complaints are registered, then it will move forward. This is a composition of grievance redressal cell, constitution, composition of GRC committee. There we can, principal sir will be Dr. Raman Dang, chairman, chairperson, vice principal Dr. H.N. Shivkumar, vice chairman, myself, Dr. Ansuya Patil, as a convener in the GRC committee. Then Hippargi sir, Dr. Subhash Karki sir, Dr. Vanita Somshekar, Dr. will be the other members of GRC committee, and student member Ms. Siali is a member of the GRC committee. Types of grievances, there are several types of grievance, individual grievance, group grievance, policy grievance. Individual grievance, complaint that an action by management has violated the rights of an individual as set out in the collective agreement or law or by some unfair practices. That could be individual grievance, should be discipline related to demotion, dispute, or denial of benefits. There are several types of grievance. Key features of grievance redressal procedures. Key feature, yes, it is a fairness, facilitates for representation of any complaint. The procedural steps, there are certain steps, sub steps are involved in that, promptness. These are the several important features of GRC. Grievance redressal procedure, yes, once the grievance or complaint from the student get registered, yes, it will be once it is get registered, once it is reported, then verification and consultation with the concerned authority will be made. Then it is forwarded to the GRC committee, grievance committee, redressal committee. Then it is next step is forwarded to a principal, then secretary. Finally, it will be discussed in the general body meeting. This is how the stepwise grievance redressal takes place. Find this about GRC. GRC is the, you know that it's a grievance redressal cell. Coming to anti-sexual harassment cell. Anti-sexual harassment cell is a form to prevent sexual assault, rape, and other related crimes on girl students. The main objective, main goal of constituting this committee is to prevention of sexual harassment, to ensure safe environment for girl candidates in the college campus and hostel. Sexual harassment in any form is unacceptable behavior and should not be tolerated by anyone. It undermines our ability to work and to feel like effective, empowered people in the world. So it's a crime, sexual harassment. Anti-sexual harassment committee is constituted in our college. Yeah, stop violence against women, say no to sexual harassment. Committee members, chairman, myself, Dr. Ansuya Patil, then member of anti-sexual harassment cell, faculty members, Dr. Rini, then Dr. Ashwini, Mrs. Apurva, non-teaching members, then Varlakshmi, NGO members, member is from NGO, non-government organization member, Ms. Sharmila John, then from the police department, member is Kavita Bai, then the warden, hostel warden will be a member of anti-sexual harassment, Mrs. Geeta Rao, girls hostel warden. Then students representative, Mrs. Prajila, PG student. Then yeah, these are the students representative from UG level, and then PG level, Miss Aditi. There are the committee members. So this is brief about three committees which are existing in our institution. That's the anti-ragging committee, a grievance redressal committee, and then anti-sexual harassment cell. So with this brief, I would like to end my talk. If you have any questions regarding these three committees, you are free to approach. Yes, do you have any questions regarding these three committees? The other committees?
Yes.
You respond me? I'm getting some queries. Let me end the session. You have any queries?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Hope you don't have any queries.
No.
Thank you, sir.
No, ma'am.
Come you one second.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Thank you.